Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Wally McGee My Career series here in NBA 2K14. Wally and the Spurs working hard to get on a winning track here, trying to keep up with the Oklahoma City Thunder. That's a nice play for a steal and assist for Wally, but the team falls short again. Tim Duncan not feeling so good about what's been going on lately, this losing record they've got in the first half of the season. And if the team's not happy, you know the fans are sure not happy.
The team struggled to stay in the game tonight, and the final score ended up not being even close. Do you think there was anything you or the team could have done differently to change the outcome?
I could have played harder, I guess. I don't know, it's hard to think about that kind of thing right after a loss. For me, it usually takes a while for everything to sink in so I can process it. All I know is that I let my teammates and the coaching staff down tonight, and these guys deserve better. I'm gonna have to do a better job of playing my game and staying within my role next time.
Interesting, because Wally McGee personally graded out as an A- in that game, but he says he could have played better. You know, that's a team player there. He's not going to throw another teammate under the bus. He's not going to say that, they didn't come through. He turns it inward and says, look, I can play even better. And even though he had a pretty decent game, grade-wise there, he feels he can do more. So here comes Toronto to town, and there was a social media challenge put out there for Wally to score 10 points or more in this game. So we'll follow that as we go, as I believe that was Landry Fields there that offered that up. So Wally already with 2 points here on two made field goals. You see Kawhi Leonard trying to drive to the basket. Nice little cut by Wally McGee there. Gets the pass and puts the layup in. And he's got 4 points here. But Toronto up big in the second quarter, 13. Wow, how do we keep falling behind these teams? Every time I go to the bench, the sim just is not kind to the Spurs at all. Oh, spinning around the foul and one. Nice job working the lane right there by Wally. He's got 6 points with a chance to make it 7. With the free throw, and it is good. So 7 points, he's already well on his way to meeting that social media challenge. Nice pass underneath, make it 9. Yes, sir. They cut it to a 10-point lead at halftime. They've got a lot of work to do, though, because they really are starving for a win. And it's 53-41 here, up and under, and it rolls in. There you go. He met that social media challenge right there with that basket, 11 points. Here is Lowry trying to drive. It's going to be stripped by Wally. Here he goes, and he's looking to make a pass to Ginobili, who will lay that one home. Here we go with San Antonio's run. Can Toronto withstand this here? Well, they've got it back up to 10 points in the third quarter. Parker to Tiago Splitter to Wally McGee, who's cutting to the basket. Nice job. He's getting more and more aggressive with those cut plays right there. He's an A-minus grade once again. Working hard on defense. Running circles around the Raptors. Getting this ball off to Tiago Splitter, who gets the slam and the foul. That's an assist with a steal leading to a score. Nice job. They've cut into the 74-69. McGee to Splitter. He's double-teamed. Back to McGee. Double-team moves over to him. Back to Splitter. Nice passing play. They get the foul and the bucket, and they can cut this to a 2-point lead. Splitter does just that. 74-72, 3 minutes remaining. It's now 76-72. Big play here as they need a bucket. Down to Tim Duncan, low. Into McGee. Count it! He's got another basket, and it's just a 2-point lead once again. Okay, let's play some defense here. Well, Toronto has reached a 5-point lead. Now Tim Duncan, oh no, he cannot hit with about a minute and a half left. Look out, because here comes a wide open alley-oop. Oh, we got to play some defense. Let's get back. Oh, boy. It gets away from us again. 84-78 is the final. The Raptors, who had a worse record than we did, came into our home floor and took the game from us. This is not Spurs basketball. This is not your dad's Spurs team right here, as things seem to be getting away from them quickly. Let's go to the podium now and Wally McGee.
It was another rough fourth quarter for you guys, as you weren't able to seal the deal at the end of the game. Do you feel like your team lost this game, or the other team won it?
We lost it. This one's on us. We didn't execute in the fourth quarter like we needed to, and that made the difference in the end. The last few minutes is when guys got to step up and start making plays, and we didn't do that. But, you know, give them credit too. They did what they had to and kept us from getting ahead at the end. But I really feel like if we had done a few things differently, man, we would have won.
Once again, Wally not reaching for excuses. It might not be popular with the local fan support there, but he is turning that inward on the team. They've got to play better. So we upgrade a signature skill that is flashy passer level 3, and hopefully that'll help going forward.
Oh, I'm ready. Let's get this, Timmy. Make it happen, boy. Yeah.
All right. Well, I guess that's proof positive that Wally McGee is staying upbeat and trying to keep this team loose. It is Christmas Day. We got a game on Christmas Day. And you know what the Spurs want for Christmas? They're not asking for much. They would just like a win. Just win, baby. That would be the best Christmas present of them all. They need to get back on track. 2 points for Wally McGee right there. Passing to Green, who will go to Splitter. Who's going to cut to the basket? Well, eventually it's going to be Wally McGee going left hand and making that one. So he's got 4. And this is tied at 14 early. Ginobili's going to stop and pop that 3 and give the Spurs the lead. Maybe they can get a win for Christmas here. Wally McGee is going to get into the lane. Up and under. Draws a foul. It will not go. But he will get 2 free throws. So the first of 2 is good. As he gets set to shoot the second here and maybe give him a 3-point lead in the first quarter. Nope, that's going to rattle off. So he gets just 1 of 2. And the halftime score ends up being 44-39. Houston in the lead. So James Harden and company doing work as well and continuing to keep the Spurs down. Here you see Kawhi Leonard's going to go to Tiago Splitter. That's a nice cut to the basket by Wally McGee. He will draw another foul. And let's see what he can do right here. He sinks the first one. Let's try to make 2 of 2 this time and make it a successful trip to the line. Cuts the lead to 11 with that free throw right there as he makes 2 of 2. So he's got 7 points. The Spurs are rallying big time and cutting into this lead. It's 64-58 in the fourth now. Here's a pass to Duncan. McGee trying to get himself open, but Duncan will get the basket on his own. Nice there. He cuts it to a 4-point lead. Oh, it's back out to 8 now with 3:28 remaining. Parker looking to drive. Finds McGee. He will get the layup. Good job right there getting another bucket. He's got 9 points. It's a 6-point game. Oh, Wally's not getting up though. Is he injured? Oh, I was really worried at this point. Looked like he may have been injured. Does get to a full sprint eventually, so I guess he's all right. Down 8 here though. Ginobili gets the ball to Wally McGee. What's he going to try to do with this? Well, he's going to try to get a teammate open. That doesn't happen, but they give him a free lane to the basket on the baseline. Nice. Okay, 6-point lead. 72-64 now. It's an 8-point lead. He's going to cut right in and get another bucket right there. Actually, they call goaltending. It looked like it went anyway. He gets 13, but look it. Things fall apart on the stretch again. It's an 83-66 loss. Only thing that the Spurs get for Christmas is a lump of coal delivered by the Houston Rockets. Ouch, that's gotta hurt.
0 wins so far on this latest homestand has to be tough to swallow. How are you feeling about the team's performance lately and the inability to take games on your home court?
It's frustrating, man. Really frustrating. The fans deserve better than this. First and foremost, we gotta take care of business here at home, you know? If we can't do that, we can't expect to do much of anything in this league. We've got some serious work to do to keep this from happening again.
I'll tell you what's been frustrating has been playing this series so far. Every time he's on the court, you know, we do all right. We seem to hold our own. Every time I go off the court and things get simmed, things seem to fall apart, you know. I guess things fall apart when we're on the court at times too, but I mean, getting pretty decent team grades, and yet the things are not just gelling together here for us to get the win. Come on, we're the San Antonio Spurs. It's been 14 years in a row of 50 wins or more. The word internally with the team is that Greg Popovich is considering making a move in his starting lineup, making a change. Could this signal the very first start for Wally McGee in the young career? Well, I know Wally would welcome that idea. If Popovich wants to make the move and pull him off the bench and put him into a starting role, he would be all in favor of that. Giving him a chance to show what he can do in an increased role. So it's off to Dallas next. And oop, Is that a preview? Was he in the starting lineup? Have to come back next time and see how things go. Wally McGee coming back next. We'll see you then.